out pretty well.
Little Peter out. So Dave, at some point we're probably going to want to start using that water.
Okay. For what they talked about, flow over a gravity current or something, flow over a plate.
Well, the manner doesn't set in for a long time.
Oh, okay.
It's, you know, it's a self-formed feature. It's,
there's no sediment moving yet.
Yeah. As I recall last time with the low dam, we sort of just squeezed in under the 1 hour duration of our videotapes. So I'm expecting this to take, you know, on the order of 45 minutes.
This is a little bit higher.
Yeah. Although we don't want to flood this, we're fairly close to the brink here, into flooding the surface.
I mean, what's the, Dave, what are you at now? What's your inflow rate?
Just know what it is, below the meter level.
Oh.
An eyeball estimate would suggest that his inflow rate is very similar to what we're getting out of the drain right now.
Oh, really?
Yeah. On the order of, you know, 2 liters a minute.
Well, I think increasing, trying to increase it slightly would be,
okay.
Would be in order.
Just keep an eye on the pressure, Roger.
Yeah.
So let's, we're going to try to bump it up a little bit.
Okay.
Let me walk into some visual feedback here.
Okay.
It's almost there.
What's that?
Is it not registering on the dial?
No, it's registering again.
Okay, let's try it right there for a while.
Dick.
Yep.
You realize we've been cheating on manual focus all this time?
No, I did not realize that.
So a lot, whatever you've been taking since the last time.
Whatever I've been taking today has been out of focus then.
Probably.
Did you set it on manual earlier?
Whenever I use it for the photogrammetry, then yes. So
oh, I didn't realize you were using that for photogrammetry.
I did take some. So it's probably been that way for a while, actually.
That's too bad.
Well, you just have to set up. That's the way to start with this.
Yeah. Probably some of them will be in closer.
Well, didn't you guys look through see that it wasn't focused?
I noticed that it was not focusing just now, yes.
Well, we're making this, progress.
I just picked up this camera.
Yeah.
I haven't been making no progress.
Had an opportunity to realize.
Well, it's going into the
It's all infantry.
It gets a little bit cluttered.
Another slight increment of inflow.
Well, it's about the same, you know. But if you did it more, you'll have, it doesn't look like, you know, I'm using these rocks as a gauge, so. If it drops below, well, actually it could, it looks like it is losing.
I think it's actually falling?
Yeah.
The water level is falling?
Just a hair.
So, Dave, we're going to try easing it up again a little bit.
It's quite a bit. Well, we'll try it again.
Back it up a teeny bit.
Okay, let's try it right there.
Okay.
Fortunately, there's a rock that's right on the crest. That's a rock right there.
You're trying to get friction to warm my hand, so it's not working.
Pretty good sapping features at this point.
There's a kind of a crack that's open here.
That looks like a construction flaw.
Oh, no. Right.
The first trickle is just about to the edge.
Yep. So while it's building a delta here, it starts to meander back up. Is that what happens?
Yeah.
Because it's, yeah.
We'll just have to watch.
Okay.
I frankly don't recall if I remember.
It requires patience.
Yeah, let's see that pebble right there. Yeah. It's a good page. Right there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, no, it's hanging steady right now. It's moving a little bit of settling. Very, very small now.
Yeah, a little bit more.
Well, we could, I can switch a day if you want to actually watch one of these things.
Well, at some point we'll reach a stage where he doesn't have to tend that anymore. We could just leave it set steady way. It's this process of just trying to get it going.
Yeah, you get all the cameras set up and then, you know, have it piped back to the unit and sit there and watch it from back.
Watch it on TV?
Yeah.
Blocking the flow.
Mm-hmm. Doesn't take much.
Much like the confetti before.
Loose it a little more.
Yeah.
Look at those little miniature levees that have formed. Delicate little features.
Well, the water level's hanging pretty steady, but it's up to you guys.
Well, if we can manage to drive more through the slot without raising the water level, that would be
handy if the one will be much
the worst case scenario is you run out of tape right before it runs away. No time to change it. So you have a.
You can tell by looking at it, yeah, but I also know what time we turned them on. So roughly speaking, at noon, we're going to run out of tape on most of these cameras.
It's 40 minutes away. That should be plenty of time.
I would think so.
You can see a wedding front spreading out around.
Yeah, you can. Yeah. So.
Do you have a timestamp on those photos?
Not the still photos, no. Oh, you mean the overheads?
Well, your still photos.
No, not these. Film cameras that had a special back you could put on to generate the timestamp.
Right. Well, now, of course, you can get something that will give it a
digital. Yeah.
Yeah, that would be the cat's meow. Everything's locked into GPS, and, basically. satellite time and synchronizing clocks.
So how long until the thing is
up? About 40 minutes until the end of our tapes. My guess is that that's plenty. Yeah, it's, you know, starting to do its thing a little bit.
Well, it's contributing to the wedding front now on that one side.
Yeah.
What's it on that seat?
The bird's foot delta.
Yeah.
It's going to hit that wet zone, that's
right.
The point.
Yeah, it, my guess is it won't have to get to the rubber sheet.
Take off. It'll be interesting to see, though, if it goes through that same meandering channel phase that the others did with the lowdowns. I think we only observed that before with the 55s.
Yeah.
So this is a bit higher.
Yeah.
It's like walking into a dark closet.
Well, I guess right now, if you watch this develop, this is not going to happen.
I'm guessing that if it happens, it's going to be quite a bit more subdued.
Kind of cut the straight down.
Yeah, so the time
being.
Mm-hmm.
Don't have to go back. I don't know if that doesn't get it. Yeah, I mean, it's always a fun thing, but I have a couple of books for it.
All right, we're getting close to 3 meters again. 45 minutes. It's starting to happen. I think it's all going to unfold here within the next half hour.
Water level is it came up a little bit, but like about a millimeter.
Yeah, this is just the way the channel's getting big enough now that it can accommodate quite a bit more discharge.
Oh yeah, there's some
more. There's nothing driving.
What's the technical
term? That's the other part of the analysis. Yeah.
Kind of 146
degrees. He's got this guy.
He doesn't have that.
The wedding from produced by that.
Roger's saying that there's a wedding front underneath that channel.
Correct.
Because of infiltration that is not captured in the type of modeling that Jonathan is doing. And that's correct.
Since you were telling me what that is.
That's true. Okay. Yeah, well, when we build the dam, the sample,
that leaves a radically three-dimensional problem.
Yeah.
When you built the dam, you put the wood in and you just kind of think that's the one.
I mean, I know know you guys don't think the trigger is important, but I think that's, you know, it is. But in terms of the trigger, I think that process is affecting you.
Certainly it makes a difference as to whether or not you develop a kind of a saturated or nearly saturated zone under that channel, just because it reduces the infiltration.
It allows it to progress farther down the slope.
What do you mean it reduces the
infiltration? Because you no longer have a capillary pressure gradient helping to drive the water through directly underneath that little channel. I think that helps. It helps keep the water flowing, basically. It's losing less to the substrate as you diminish that capillary potential gradient underneath it.
If it loses less, it allows it to flow farther down the slope.
It seems to transport that fish rail without any problem.
Yeah, it does. Up here, it seems like the waves it produces as it goes vertical will, if the candle channel's not that deep enough, it blows on fast.
Just an FYI, we're up to about 3 liters a minute.
Okay. Yeah, and where the meanders started last time was down more towards the lower, and they kind of worked their way up.
Meandering is tied up with sediment transport.
Although there's subtle indications of it up there or near you, Joe. There's a little point bar that's formed on the opposite shore.
Mm-hmm. You want a few hand-fed particles?
There's one.
Yeah. Not doing any more on that thing.
Okay.
That big wrap. Okay.
See if that wrap plugs it up.
I don't think it's going to.
So I'd say you can throw a few more in there.
In fact, the gradient's picked up. You know,
yeah.
It's transporting enough sediment that the gradient's picked up quite a bit.
I think we bypassed whatever slight tendency for meandering there was. We're past that.
Yeah, I tend to agree. I don't think
it's incising.
I don't think it is going to meander.
It's incised too much. But those waves, I think, they have an effect. Yes. It's got a lot of energy now. I mean, that. There's a fair amount. down cutting pretty fast, right? You see that? And straightening out.
When I say important, I guess I mean I think it's probably somewhat unique to the peculiarities of our experience. Yeah, I'm not sure if it's a general phenomenon.
Yeah, you should look at the front, we're getting little stars.
Yeah, maybe we should shoot a few photos of those. Probably somebody should stay here and man this photo station so somebody else could grab that.
I can get it.
I can do that.
How's your flow rate, Jonathan?
3 liters a minute.
What's your flow rate, Dave?
2.1 gallons. It's actually 2.15.
Okay.
All right.
You took photos when there's a pretty even distribution of confetti all along the channel. I could probably even, might be able to get sort of a gradient along the channel from the photogrammetry.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's good.
Well, let's give that a try.
Where there's no, confetti, I can't get anything. Can I load it up a little?
Sure. Can't hurt to have a little more at this point.
It's starting to size that thing.
So we need to snap a few photos, is that?
I've been snapping photos all along.
Yeah, if you can get one when there's stuff all the way along it.
Yeah.
Great. Yeah, that's good idea, Matt.
Because
otherwise, getting the gradient
is really close.
So, yeah, I think
cool.
You're right. It's mainly what you put at the point where you go along.
Yeah.
pretty saturated down below. Triggered before. I don't know why I think it's wax when I look at this.
I'm going to bust out the big gun outside.
Sure.
Roger, why don't you and I trade places? I think it would make more sense for you to be on that side of me.
Okay.
You can pull that some of that cable out as well. Remember, no hands.
Although we'll have to. If you're standing right there, I'll have a challenge reaching that.
Can you get around to the other side?
Can you get to the other side of that, that upright?
Camera here, too.
I just looped it through. If you pass it back around, it'll give you some kind of shape.
Yeah, that's better.
Plenty of confetti out there.
Is confetti causing any problems, Dale?
No, I don't think so. It's past that point.
Yeah, it's way too much energy. So starting to cut through that top film.
So the flow rate out of here has picked up a little.
Really?
It's above 3 liters a minute.
Interesting. That might be because some water delivery through the channel there.
Yeah. That's what I'm guessing.
Surface flood.
Yeah.
That's okay. We've had that before. As long as it doesn't get away from us.
Let's leave it as long as
we can get by our thing instead. That's not the nice thing to have steady.
A chunk of our delta has just slumped away.
Roger, let's dust it in.
Back to the right and kind of intercept that slump, action might really become rapid.
Yeah, I think that'd be the trigger. It's still infiltrating quite a bit.
I'm still on the camera, dude.
Yeah, that's fine. Right, you keep it.
Starting to come back. Oop.
Okay, now things could get in.
Yep. Yep, it's starting to cut through that. We've got down, it's now down a little finger get down there. A little bit more.
Yeah, but we've been at this stage before. We did it very much the same stage earlier.
There's still quite a bit of infiltration though at the end of this. As they pop over that edge there.
There goes another slump.
Got 20 minutes of videotape left.
Yeah, we're not in a position at this point to do anything about increasing inflow.
No, we're not. We'll
flood the top.
Exactly. We just have to wait. And what we'll do, you know, if we start getting real tight on the videotape, we'll just swap out one of those cameras at a time so that we'll try to get continuous overlap.
We just formed a step, Joe.
Well, there have been steps, incipient steps kind of forming, and then they get washed out. Been happening over and over again. The fact that the toe keeps sliding away is a
that's not something we've seen before.
That's a first.
Okay, it's starting to downcut quite a bit. I would say that
there's a little bit of a meander down there now.
I think at this point we're a runaway. Very close. But
it's kind of like a debris flow fan down there. It's losing flows.
Yeah, there's a lot of energy right there. As it down cuts, it's going to steepen the channel back down. This is it. There's a step there, Joe.
I wonder if what we're seeing here is simply largely a manifestation of the sediment going in denser. Because it was damper when we placed it, and it's more compact and behaving a bit differently. Do you have any bulk densities yet, Francis?
No, because Jonathan has my book.
Ah.
So, I haven't gotten to the calculation yet.
But there are some samples that have been dried at this point.
Yeah.
All, All of the samples have been dried, so I'm at the calculation stage.
It's really downsizing a lot right now. That's going to like.
Sentiment is denser. I think it's remarkably sensitive to that.
It's still cutting back though, and I think that when that gets back.
Oh, it'll happen. I think it's eventually going to happen. There's also a big white rock in the channel, kind of a critical point there.
Oh. Yeah, that's going to roll that guy down a little bit, I guess. That channel's getting steeper.
Yeah.
Thing is, there's no real step.
No.
It's just a big hump. Steep.
It's a steep
channel.
Yeah.
There's just been, it has really evolved rather differently.
It just straightened itself out, so I think it's on its way.
Yeah.
It's going to down cut back. The steps are more subtle, though, Joe. I think they're still there. Like there's one right where that thing is collapsing right now.
It's a nice game.
The end of the entry there, it becomes
Well, that's what happened before with our low dams. Right. We've got a similar thing going on.
We're still flooding the surface.
That flooding may lead to an asymmetrical collapse.
Is the flow at the
look what's happened.
Oh yeah, this is a new thing.
Now you are building a debris. That's a debris can.
Well, I think that's the reason we don't have an abrupt step, because we built that big thick fan.
It's a new thing.
It's starting to take more flow.
Yeah, we have a micro
step at this point.
Yeah. It's just when it gets back to the side channel, it's gonna.
Thing about it, you get these steps start migrating, and then a block falls in and totally resets the system.
Oh, okay.
Like that.
The dike has been plugged.
That'll help. Get ready.
10 to 12.
Yeah, so we got 10 minutes, huh? It's gonna be close.
Here.
Yeah, just
yeah, just don't step in any closer.
Okay. You want to go to the dark and east or not?
I started my timer when this initiative came in the breach, and it's been almost 47 minutes now.
Yeah.
So, usually they're like...
Coming up nice.
Yeah, I mean, like, we've got them up to, like, 36, but...
So this one's being relatively slow?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Because we have this thing at the bottom of this. Which we haven't had before.
Uh-huh.
To the success.
Uh-huh. Have the others been more steeply faced?
No, they've always been the same structure, like in terms of like building the dam.
Uh-huh.
It was maybe more dense and saturated at the bottom. Mm. Before because we had wetter sand.
Uh-huh.
But overall, the radiant is really restricted by the presence of that big
dam.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. I'm surprised at how pulsy the flow seems to be.
Wait.
But that second, like, intro is really interesting.
I think there's potential here for this to be a completely different animal.
Well, as long as there's water back here. That it may just kind of gradually peter out, right? Because it never gets that steep grade.
Yeah, and it may do an effective job of draining itself before it ever goes into that kind of runaway phase. I don't know. Still got a lot of water.
This stuff just came back.
But actually, now it's starting to kind of migrate. That steep section is going up.
Yeah, okay, we're eroding up at the, the head of that channel now.
Yeah, and you can see that migrating feature. When that gets back there, we're going to go.
It's very close to the point where it would start down here, I think.
If we can just pop out and...
That's deepening now and capturing more of the flow that's been going off on the side. Not by much.
I'm going to throw some potato down here at the end of the day.
Running a real race here with the videos.
Just let me know at this point if you want me to start plugging things.
Sure, we'll have that one, but it sure be nice to have more than that.
You want me to go swap out?
No, I really think we're getting close.
We're real close to full.
The flow has gone critical now up at the section, so I really, really think we're going to make it.
It's eroding and deepening there now. So it's in a runaway state. Starting to get a little
plunge.
What's
going
to go now?
Joe,
let's go ahead.
Right now?
Sure.
Perfectly symmetrical can.
Well, that experiment was a real one-off.